Okay, so 2 years after the discovery of Edwin Hubble, George Lemaître proposed the primeval atom in 1931. So, in primeval atom theory, according to Lemaître, he proposed that the universe expanded from initial point. So, it means to say the universe at the very beginning is very small, which he called the primeval atom billions of years ago. So after a certain time, all those galaxies will rush together. So Lemaître put forth the idea that there was once a primordial atom or primeval atom which had contained all the matter in the universe that was called singularity. Next, we have the discovery of cosmic microwave background. So, on May 20, 1964, American radio astronomers Robert Wilson and Arno Penzias were working together at the 50-foot Longhorn antenna in Homedale, New Jersey, at what was then Bell Telephone Laboratories. So when they pointed the antenna at empty patches of the sky, the researchers stumbled on a low-level hiss. So this as sound, or this mysterious sound, produced constant noise that would turn out to be the cosmic radiation, or also called the cosmic microwave background. Next, we have the cosmic inflation theory. So this theory is the supporting theory of the Big Bang. It is a main focusing in the quantum fluctuation or the science of the small elements of matter. So in cosmic inflation, the most recent cosmic inflation theory is proposed by physicists Alan Guth and Andre Lindy in 1980s. So according to this theory, the cosmic inflation of Guth and Lindy, the early universe went under rapid expansion in space-time, just like what happened in the Big Bang theory, because of expansion in space-time. Continuous, or when you say rapid, this is a very fast movement of energy that expand. That is the reason why we have the expanding universe. So the theory states that the early universe was a rapidly expanding bubble of pure vacuum energy. So when we say expanding bubble of your vacuum energy, in a vacuum energy, it has an empty space of energy, but because of a very hot temperature in that quantum fluctuation, there is an expansion that occur. So it did not have any matter or radiation. It is an empty space of energy. So after the expansion and cooling due to inflation, so the potential energy was converted into kinetic energy of matter and radiation. So there is already light that core. So in this case, CMB is observable, and then a Big Bang occurred because of the extremely hot dense condition of matter. So in this cosmic inflation theory, it realizes us that this is the first happening in the formation of our universe. And after this cosmic inflation, Big Bang occur. So mas nauna yung cosmic inflation theory kaysa sa Big Bang theory. But they are all in terms of expansion, not with this explosion. So seconds after the explosion or after the expansion, matter began to clump together. So the first atom is now observable in the inflationary universe. Eventually, stars were formed and then galaxies. The universe continued to expand up to the present time. So we have the timeline of the inflationary universe. So the Big Bang, after a cosmic inflation, the Big Bang occurred in an infinitely dense moment of 13.7 billion years. So in this case, the universe is born from a single point called singularity, wherein it is a small point that is very hot, very dense, and very small. And because of this singularity, it creates a quantum fluctuation that result to the inflationary universe or continuous expansion of the universe. So in inflation, a mysterious particle or force accelerates the expansion. So no one can tell what is that mysterious particle or force that accelerates the expansion. Some models inflate the universe by a factor of 10 to the 26 in less than 10 to the negative 32 seconds. So it is very fast, no? From 10 to the exponent of negative 26 to 10 from the exponent of negative 32 seconds. Then after that, cosmic microwave background is now observable after 380,000 years. So loose electrons cool enough to combine with protons. So in this case, no, atom is now forming the first or primarily ingredients of the whole universe is now creating in this kind of scenario. So the universe becomes transparent, and when we say transparent, it forms light. No, it forms light. The microwave background begins to shine or develop. After that, dark ages. No, there are clouds of dark hydrogen and gas, and also after that, the first stars form because of gas clouds collapse, or the fusion of stars also begin. The clouds of dust and gas collapses or combined with one another to form the first star. Then after so many years or millions of years, galaxy formation occur. Galaxy causes galaxies to form. So merge and drift, dark energy accelerates the expansion of the universe, but at a much lower rate than what was happening in the inflation or in the cosmic inflation of the inflationary universe. Next, we have the steady state theory. It is another theory about the formation of the universe. So in this theory, it states that the universe is always expanding. It also states that the new matter is constantly formed as the universe continues to expand. The older bodies eventually became out of sight as a consequence of their increasing distance and the rate of recession. So as you can see in the steady state theory, determined that the universe is expanding, but it doesn't change in appearance now. As you can see, from a very small picture of our universe, the dots, not the space between the dots, doesn't change kahit lumaki pa yung universe, expand pa yung universe. Hindi nagbabago yung spacing ng bawat dots or ng bawat galaxy. Density of matter is constant over time. So this theory, it has no beginning, it has no end. The universe is always expanding. So the steady state theory says that although the universe expanding, its appearance doesn't change. It first proposed by Sir James Jeans in 1920, and revised by Sir Fred Hoyle, Sir Herman Bondi, and Thomas Gould in the year 1948. This is an alternative or another theory that opposes the Big Bang theory. So because it opposes is the opposite of the Big Bang theory, it has a variety of evidences that contradict this theory. So evidence that contradict the steady state theory are as follows. Okay, so the first one, galactic bodies such as quasars and radio galaxies were found a long way from the sun and far distances from space. Now, so it is proved that the idea that similar bodies are created and found everywhere because of this discovery of quasars and radio galaxies that found a long way from the sun. Formation of the solar system. So in the formation of the solar system, a star system, also called stellar system, is a small number of stars that orbit each other. So in every stellar system, it has a center, no? That is also called the center of the stellar system. It should be noted that the Earth belongs to the solar system, which is a type of a star system, because the sun is a star. So one of the best example of a stellar system is our solar system. Various theories strive to explain the chemical and physical differences of the planets and the regularity of orbital motions and directions. So we have different theories that explain the origin of the star system or the origin of our solar system. The first one is the nebular hypothesis. So it seems to be the most accepted theory based on the consistency of its premises or evidences to current observation. Just like Big Bang theory, it is the most accepted theory. It is developed by Immanuel Kant and Pierre Simon Laplace in 18th century. So it proposes that around 4.5 billion years ago, a star system was formed from a rotating cloud of gas. So this rotation of clouds of gas was also called nebula. So a nebula is an extremely hot gas of dust and cloud particles. So when the gas cooled, the nebula began to shrink. And as it became smaller, then it rotated faster because it became smaller, the weight decreased. As it became smaller, it shrink. It rotated faster, casting off rings of gas and forming a disc-like shape. Just like what we see in our images. It is the formation of the rotating cloud of gas that is also called nebula. So the centrifugal force from the nebula, because of a fast rotation, rotation and gravitational force from the mass of the nebula form the rings of gas outside. As the nebula continued to shrink, these rings condensed into various densities of planets. So these rings, around these rings, it creates dense amount of planets and also their satellites, because every planets in our solar system has its own satellites. So the remaining part of the nebula, which has the most mass, form the sun. So yung sun nasa gitna, it is the remaining part of the nebula which has the most mass. Next theory is the planetesimal or planetesimal theory. So in this theory, it describes that the formation of the planet as asserted in the nebular hypothesis, a hypothesis, it is being described in the formation of the planets. So it was proposed by Victor S. Savronov in 1941 and developed by D.C. Chamberlain and F.R. Moulton. So this theory states that in the early period of the solar system, planets were formed from the accretion of small space bodies. So pag sinabi nating accretion, it is a process wherein small particles of matter or small particles of dust and gas of the planets eventually collided with one another and stick together to form elementary planets or small planets, which was called planetesimal. So the gravity of the space bodies attracted space objects because of the accretion, until the effect of their gravity reduced due to the accretion, which also increased the size of the planetesimal. From the very beginning, the small space bodies or space objects, they are very small in sizes until it become bigger and bigger to form different sizes of planets. Next, we have the tidal theory. It was developed by James Jeans and Sir Harold Jeffries in 1917. So according to the theory, a star passed close to the sun, where the tidal force or secondary effect of gravitational pull between the passing star and the sun draw large amount of matter out of the sun and the passing star. So in this theory, the sun is already there now. The sun is already existing. So it happens that the star pass or lumapit siya sa sun, wherein it create tidal force. Kaya nga siya tinawag na tidal theory. And this tidal force creates a secondary effect of gravitational pull between the passing star and the sun. And because of that, the star draw large amounts of matter out of the sun or revolving the sun, and it creates eventually planetesimal or small bodies of planets. And after time goes by, it creates the formation of the planets or the solar system that we have now. So some of the drawn out matter quickly cooled to become solid bodies called planetesimals. Others grew in size because of colliding and sticking together with passing objects in space, eventually forming large clumps and gathering more and more matter. So in this theory, it is also backed up by old meteorites found on Earth, chemically dated back to the about 4.5 billion years, the time approximate to be the formation of the solar system. Because of this, this discovery of this old meteorite, so nalaman ng mga cosmologists na yung approximate na age ng ating planet Earth is also nearest 4.5 billion years old. So that is also the age of the formation or the creation of our solar system.